Dr. Joe Dispenza é autor best-seller do New York Times, pesquisador, conferencista e consultor corporativo. Ele realiza uma brilhante interface entre ciência e espiritualidade, integrando com maestria os conhecimentos da física quântica, neurociência e epigenética para explorar a ciência por trás das remissões espontâneas. Ele usa esse conhecimento para ensinar as pessoas a curar seus corpos de problemas de saúde, fazer mudanças significativas em suas vidas e desenvolver sua consciência. Desde 2010, ele está com uma equipe de cientistas para pesquisar os efeitos da meditação no coração e nas funções cerebrais, na resposta imunológica e na saúde geral da mente e do corpo. Dr. Joe, é um imenso prazer apresentar o seu trabalho para o público brasileiro, especialmente aos meus seguidores, que já viram falar de você muitas vezes. Dr. Joe, no seu livro Você é o Placebo, você traz inúmeros casos de remissão espontânea de várias doenças. Qual o roteiro prático da autocura para que nos tornemos o nosso próprio médico quântico?
Well, this is something, once again, that I spend a lot of time doing my best demystifying. And when we started seeing, Wallace, these very profound changes in people's health during a weekend workshop, that was more than 10 years ago. I saw people step out of wheelchairs and people have spontaneous remissions right during that weekend event. That's when I knew we had to start doing measurements. We had to start studying the brain. We started studying the body. We started studying the immune system, neurotransmitters. We started measuring the energy around people's bodies. We looked at if they can control their autonomic nervous system and could they control how their heart beats and could they have an influence on all these different elements, gene expression, telomere lengths. I wanted to measure everything to be able to understand that there's a formula, a process that can take place with personal change and transformation. And so when I looked at the placebo, by the way, there's no real study that can be done in science right now that's not a triple-blind placebo study. In other words, you always have to account for the mind in every single pharmaceutical or drug study. And when I started researching the placebo, I was fascinated by the fact that you could give someone a sugar pill, a saline injection, perform some false surgery or procedure, and a certain percentage of those people will accept, believe, and surrender to the thought that they're getting the actual substance or treatment, and they begin to manufacture the exact pharmacy of chemicals equal to the substance that they think they're taking. Now, the question is, is it the sugar pill or the inert substance? Is the placebo doing the healing? Or is it the body's innate capacity to heal by thought alone? So then, if 80% of people that are in a depression study that are given a placebo respond as well as a person who's giving the actual antidepressant, and you do brain scans on these people that are given a placebo, and you see profound changes in their brain. That change isn't in their mind. It's in their brain. That means that they're making their own pharmacy of antidepressants by thought alone. So then you give someone an aspirin, and it's white and it's round and there's a line through the middle, and they take it, and they notice their pain goes away. The moment they notice their pain go away, they remember what caused it, that little white pill. So they take the pill again the next day, and their pain goes away the next day. And they take the pill the next day, and the inflammation goes down the next day. Then the doctor substitutes, or researcher, just a pill that looks just like that aspirin. But now it's just starch. And when they take the pill, they report that their pain levels go down. So then that pill becomes a symbol of possibility. So if the doctor says, this is a new drug, Wallace, that's going to cause your condition to go down, here's the research, this is what we've studied, and a certain percentage of those people, that pill will be a symbol, and they'll begin to think about them being well. They'll start to select a new potential in the quantum field and see themselves well. Now, that's not enough. That's a clear intention. But the majority of those people will start feeling optimistic. They'll start feeling inspired. They'll start feeling grateful. And they're combining a clear intention with an elevated emotion. And they're changing their state of being by thought alone. Now, here's the question. Do you need the sugar pill to change your state of being? Or can you just, independent of that pill, marry a clear intention with an elevated emotion, select a new potential in the quantum field, embrace the emotion before the event occurs, and every single day change your state of being? Now, here's the key. People are so entitled to think that they've done it once and it should take away their health condition, and they go back to the same identity or the same personality. In the triple-blind placebo studies they did on depression, those people took the placebo for 8 weeks in a row. Every day they took that pill, and every day they thought about that new future. And every day they were changing their state of being. So then if it took 8 weeks for people to heal from depression by taking a sugar pill because they changed their state of being, then it may take 8 weeks for a person to finally change their state of being so that the condition is finally gone. So we've come up with a formula, an understanding that when you combine brain coherence with heart coherence and the interaction between these two profound organs, one has to do with the thought, the other has to do with the feeling, to change a person's state of being and create coherence in both parts, brain and heart. And people do this properly, and they can change their state of being until it's familiar to them. So it's who they are. They've become that person. That's when we see significant changes take place in a person's health or in their life. Now, some people, they're at it every day. Every day they're overcoming themselves or overcoming themselves or overcoming themselves until they become somebody else. Other people, they come to a week-long event. They have a profound mystical experience. Everything lines up. It was their moment. And that interaction with energy is so profound that energy influencing matter causes an instantaneous change in the person's health. Now, if you asked me a year ago or 2 years ago, if I thought we would see a lot of this, I would say, maybe a few. But now we're actually able to induce it. We're actually able to predict it when it's going to happen. And we're actually able to replicate it. So now we're looking at some scientific principle that says that when a person begins to learn the formula for personal change and transformation, they can produce dramatic changes in their health as well as dramatic changes in their life.